Everybody, it's Letitia with Tish's Dishes, and I am going to roast my green chili this year. So I am outside. So let me turn this around and show you the green chili. Okay, so this is my green chili, and so let's do this. Let's go back and let me show you. I'm going to roast it in my barbecue. I think it's easier. Watch this. Okay, let's go to my barbecue. I know this is, oh gosh, she's like all over the place. And so here is the barbecue. And you know what? I started roasting it, and you know what? See, it does the same thing how I, you know, when I do it in the oven. And what I do is, oh, it's hot. Well, like Julia Child says, gotta get your hands prepared to cook because everything's hot. I agree with her. It's easier to cook with I could fill stuff with my hands, but see, I washed them and then I put them, lay them down, and you do the same thing like when you're doing it in the oven. Same scenario, look at my video for my oven version, and it's exactly the same way. And actually, you know what? It's faster. I think it's just so much faster. And then I got me a plastic container because, you know, all the time. Okay, let's throw that in there. You could tell when they're cooked. You could throw them in there. So pretty much you could tell. Woo! Chihuahuita! Okay, sorry about that, guys. And then all I'm going to do is just move these all over. And then, hot tamale. Yeah, it's hot. Okay, and I'm going to just move these all over. We'll just move these all over. And see, we'll move these all over. I know, this video is probably a generic one for me, but I just wanted to show you because I was so psyched about roasting my chili this year. I decided to do it differently. So I have it in my barbecue, and you know what? Follow my instructions from before. Go buy it. It's almost out. Go buy it, wash it, and then you'll lay it on flat and then watch it, and as it starts to bubble, then you turn it and you can see how it's cooking really good. So this is this one is not yet. See? And then what I'll do is I'll add some more on, but pretty much I'm like rolling on this one. It's like, God, it's cooking fast, which is kind of nice because that's the key component, is the cooking part takes a long time. And like yesterday when I got my chili, this one is actually from Hatch this year. Is the store that I went to, because I didn't go to Lamatar to get any. I didn't have time this year, but this here, let's cover this, and then I got a container that I'm going to cover it, see, so it steams, and then I'm going to show you how to peel it. That's a key component. A lot of people don't know how to peel it, so on this video, you will learn how to peel chili and how to season it as well. Okay, guys, Tish's Dishes. Subscribe, like, and hit the bell. Hello. Hi, everybody. It's Letitia with Tish's Dishes. So I have my green chili that I froze. I had made it on the grill. I froze it because I didn't eat it at the time. So I'm taking it out. I'm going to put it in the microwave for 5 minutes so that it defrosts really good. And then once it comes up, you'll see the next step. Tish's Dishes. Okay, it's out of the microwave. So let's open the bag and let's move that that way. And let's just dump it in there. And so what I'm going to do, okay, let's move it onto this. So I'm going to move this here and then we're just going to peel it. See how we're peeling it off? If you have gloves, it's probably wise to use them, because if you're not used to peeling green chili, you need to be very careful because you will burn your eyes. Because you gotta remember, chili is hot and spicy. And I can even smell it, and you'll start coughing. And I try to get as much seeds as I possibly can out of it. So, see, you start to cough because it's just, pretty strong. So this is all there is to doing this. Playing with chili. There's a lot of people that like the seeds in theirs. They pretty much don't. You know, you can either leave the seeds in there, and then also you can leave the veins in there, or you can take them out. It just depends on how hot you want your chili. This year, this chili came out super duper hot. Even the mild is hot. This whole chili, this batch of this year, from my understanding, they told me this is the hottest they've seen it. Okay, so that's that. Okay, so then bring it back this way. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to dice it. Dice. So it depends on how much you're going to make. It depends on if you're just going to. I'm making this we are having hamburgers. This chili's for hamburgers tonight. Or if you have some extra, you can make some eggs. And I think they're gonna do, well, there's some chili, there's actually, then all I do is I love to put garlic salt. So be careful if you can pour a lot of garlic salt in if you like. Okay, and then the other thing is, this is a key component, I think, is you've got to squish it. Squish it together. Squish it. Squish it together. I don't know, it brings out more of the aroma of the chili than just to put it in there after you diced it. This is like the best. You can smell it. It just lets all the aroma out. This is all what the grandma used to do, my mom, everybody. I mean, it's okay to cook green chili, but if you don't squish it to let all the juices out, to let all the flavor. And that's it. That's my whole process to my making diced green chili. And this is going to be done for hamburgers. And based upon what you're going to make, if you're going to make enchiladas or green chili stew, based upon how much chili you like in it, you could double that size, triple that size. It just depends how much chili you want in it. So now this is going to be for my hamburgers. Okay, guys, Tish's Dishes, subscribe and like and hit that bell for the notifications so you get every video that comes out that's new.